In this video, I'm going to discuss a new feature which we've called collaging. An easy way to describe this feature is that you're able to add multiple images and videos into the same output screen. So let's show you how it works. Firstly, I'll preview some images in the media browser. And when I'm happy with my selections, I'll drag the photos into the mixing screen. I'll place them on separate tracks. If I press play, I can see them being introduced in the timeline. To introduce the collaging feature, I need to resize the photos. To do this, click on the segment properties icon on any of the segments. In this case, I'll select the first segment. The segment property window will open and the photograph will be shown in the video display window. In the video display area of the segment properties, we've introduced some new features. These features include the rotate path, anti-clockwise by 90 degrees, clockwise by 90 degrees, invert vertically, and invert horizontally. We've also introduced the ability to zoom in and zoom out of your video and photos. And you can do this three ways. Firstly, you can use the zoom slider to zoom in and out. We've also introduced some presets that can be accessed by right-clicking on the zoom slider and selecting an option from the drop-down menu. This is a very nice feature if you want your photos and videos to have the same zoom size and set them quickly and easily. Another way to zoom in and zoom out is to right-click on the image in the video display area and select either zoom in or zoom out. I can then use the left mouse button to zoom in and zoom out, and the cursor will be displayed as a magnifying glass. Using this feature, you are able to zoom in and out of specific areas of your image or video. To restore the video to its original default state, you can click on the Restore button. To move the image to other areas within the video display screen, I can use the vertical and horizontal offset sliders. Once you move the image or video, you will see a red border. This red border indicates the boundaries of the original frame as it's been moved. The blue border represents the limits of the frame for the selected target frame size, and no video or photos will be displayed outside this blue border. You can also move the image within the video display area by right-clicking on the window and selecting Grab. Holding down the left mouse button, you can now move the frame anywhere within the set target frame size. I can also use the play bar to see how it will be placed in the video output screen. When happy with your changes, click Close. I'll now adjust the image sizes for segments 2 and 3. Again, I can use the zoom, offset sliders, and grab function to position the images. I can also use the play bar to view my images in the video output screen. To make my collage a bit more personal, I'll add some text. To learn more about text and credits, please view the text and credits videos. I will also introduce some fades to gradually introduce my photos. If I press play, you can see the collaging function at work. Collaging also works well with multiple videos, which allows you to have multiple videos open and playing at the same time in the same video output screen. Again, resizing and moving the video frame using the segment properties works the same as with photos. Again, I'll press play to see the collaging at work.
Oh, you're tickling yourself?
When creating a mix with video and photos with different frame dimensions, you may sometimes notice the video or photo with a different frame dimension still shown in the video output screen if they're overlapping. We give you the option to prevent this by either clicking on the collage icon in the track name toolbar to disable this feature, and will prevent this from happening on any media placed in this track. Or if you want this to be prevented for the individual segment only, click on the segment properties icon and click on the disable collage button for this segment. Again, I'll press play.
Oh, whoa.
She's scared of the camera.
Another feature we've added to collaging is the ability to keep a video or photo always on top of other media when collaging. For example, here I've created a mix with multiple photos crossfaded on channel 2, and I've just introduced a video onto channel 6, which I want to collage with my slideshow. I've already resized and positioned my video using the segment properties. If I scroll through with my play bar, I can see my video, but as the timeline dictates, the next photo will override my video. However, I want my video to stay on top of the slideshow and continuously play, and collage with my photo slideshow. To do this, simply click on the Always on Top button in the track name toolbar for channel 6. Now every piece of video or photo brought into channel 6 will play on top as well. If I press play, I can see my video will play on top of my slideshow and collage with my photos. Finally, you can also use the Trakkutter to resize, position, and edit your photos and videos to assist with collaging, and then copy and paste them into the mixing window. This is covered in greater detail in the Trakkutter Part 2 video.